And now inside the world's only live-action video game, activating graphics! Ooh! Now, a question, if any of you were born ever, make a noise for me now! Yes! How I love an English audience. You people have been trained since Panto to respond to any old dumb shit. He's behind you. Oh, no, he isn't. Oh, yes, he is. That's how we're going to catch that sex offender then. If any of you were born in the 1940s, let me know.
Woo! Ha!
No one born in the 40s has ever made that sound. Unless they were dancing on the skull of a dead German pilot. No! And if you were born in the 40s, the fact that we put curtains on the windows must have freaked you the fuck out. If any of you were born in the 1950s, let me know!
Yes!
Aha! Look at you being down with the kids. Didn't say yeah, didn't say yep, didn't say yo, said yes, but with real vitriol. Ah, yes, and I'm glad that you were here, not at home, thinking, ah, yes, remember the good old days when MASH was real. Father Mulcahy was never funny. If any of you were born in the 1960s, let me know. Even if they are here, that's what marijuana did to that generation. 1970s!
Hey!
Really? I don't think I've ever had anybody do a sound effect from the fucking Beano before. Hey, chortle, chortle, chip butty. It's to be my stripper name. No! I was created in the 1980s, if any of you were born in the 1980s, let me know!
Yay!
Yes!
I love that sound.
For that sound proves something. My generation still has energy, for we are the first generation to accomplish nothing. And it's wonderful. Everyone prior to us has done something of conceivable use. They've put a man on the moon, they've cured a disease. Mr. 50's brother remembers Christ when he was a boy. Yes. Yes. Remember, little long-haired Jewish kid, he used to come around the house and throw him in the pool and he used to bounce off. You know? And when of you were born in the 1990s, let me know! Sicken me. I have such respect for every generation prior to the 1990s. What do you know? Also, may I say, God bless you for turning up dressed as the whole decade. Well done. You just need five friends to shout it's morphin time. You'll be right. The 90s generation bothers me. What do you know about pain? What do you know about suffering? What do you know about spending 9 hours downloading a picture of some woman's shoulder? And then your mother picks up the phone and ruins it for everyone. See, if you were born in the 50s, or the 40s, or the 60s, or the 70s, you, congratulations. You are the last generations who, when you were children, used to go to a magical place called outside. I've never been. I've got a 90s kid there, she'll have never seen the sky, she thinks it's a screensaver. But I was created in the 80s. We are the generation that was told, don't go outside. There is nothing for you there. Instead, come here. And behold, this is a computer.
Oh.
Is it good?
It will be.
In 30 years.
What does it do?
We know what a TV does.
Yes.
This does less. Would you like to turn it on?
I would love that.
Then first, you must find the on button. Where is it? At the back. Why, nobody knows. And if you could climb beneath the table, and you could climb up through the nest of wires, and you could find the on button, you would be rewarded by watching a screen that had once been black with an activity become black with activity. And you could experience the miracle of DOS. And the only games that ran on these computers that were heavier than they were powerful. Were text-based adventure games. And if you have ever played a text-based adventure game, then you know there are two words that shouldn't have been in that sentence. And they are adventure and game! Because what those games were you trapped in a room with a fascist Old Testament god who loved grammar.
I hated you.
And every game was the same. You're in a hole, I get out. No, that was the whole game. And that's what we're about to do. In a moment, if you are called upon to play, four options will appear on the screen behind me. Pick one of the four, try to escape the dark room. If you succeed, I will go with you to an ATM. I will withdraw £1,000. It will look suspiciously like a mugging. But if you fail, you will die. But do not be alarmed. No one goes home empty-handed. Behold the table of wonders. Do not patronize the table. It is quite clearly not a table, it is a bench fixed to the wall. Tonight, on the table of wonders, memories of a Marks and Spencer sandwich. This high self-esteem potato. And some other foods. Now, yes, the odd thing is that's the noise my dick makes when it becomes hard. It's a warning, but you always know I'm coming. Hey! When I get a disease, it becomes a fire truck. It's red, right? Something, something ambulance. Okay, now! Who amongst you will go first?
Me!
Yes! Who? Show me! You! Yes, you! Boy! What a wonderful attempted moustache! What is your name?
Will.
No! I don't like that name. You'll be called Darren. Do you like that name?
Yeah.
Shut up, Darren! Darren! You're awake to find yourself in a dark room! Pick one of these four options, boy! That's not on there, Darren. No need to be. Pardon me.
Go north.
You proceed in the direction you believe to be north. How can you be sure you're in a dark room?
Find light switch.
How will you find the light switch? You're in a dark room. You need the light switch to see. Do you see?
pipe.
Are you sure? Answer me, boy.
Yes.
Are you sure?
So?
Yes. If you're not sure, perhaps in fact you'd prefer any of these three rhyming options?
Skype.
You place your faith in telecommunications technology. But the dark room's internet is provided by Vodafone. No, Skype! You die! 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 Yes, and behold an English crowd applauding the death of their friend. Now, what prize will you take home? Yes, I say, do you have an Xbox 360 at home?
No.
Ah, then you're going to love.
Yes, connect Star Wars with the Xbox 360.
That's how the show is going to go for the next hour. Now, little proviso, as the show goes on, we will repeat ourselves. Now, there are two very popular chants in this show. Did I say popular? I meant common, but it worked for the girls at school. Not bad for improv, and I will also point out the fact that you just went, that was funny, that's all the affirmation I need. Nothing like having the laughter of the whole room fucking subtitled. There are two chants that we indulge in this show. There are several more, but these are the first and the easiest. One is the following. You die! You die! You die! You die! You die! Feel free to join in on that. Anytime anyone dies, it will make you feel tremendous. And they don't care, they're dead. The other one is this. You are weak to find yourself in a dark room! Think of it as a special greeting. Now, who will go now? So I will.
Yo.
Yo.
I did say yo.
Well, thug life. Bitches ain't shit. Does this mean something to you? You boy. What is your name?
John.
No. It's Darren. Hip hop Darren.
Darren!
All together, gang.
You are going to find yourself in a dark room.
Pick an option, Darren.
Why?
Because it's dark, Darren. And a room, Darren! And you're awake in it, Darren!
Turn on the light switch.
That's always been your problem, Darren! Self-esteem too high! Think you can turn on anything?
Even inanimate objects! What? Would you turn the light switch on with?
Off the light switch.
Ignoring my question entirely. Rude. You look for the light switch.
You can't look for the light switch. You would need the light switch to look. What part of this don't you fucking understand?
Sleep.
Worn out.
Worn out from this attack of logic.
You sleep. And when sleep is ended,
you're going to find yourself in a dark room.
Which one?
The green one.
Congratulations, you're wearing green check pockets. It's a hideous fashion choice, and you would have known because the room's so dark. But I decided to tell you! Listen to him laughing to that panic attack. Pick an option, boy.
Check pockets.
Congratulations! Your pockets were made in the Czech Republic! It doesn't help you escape, but it's lovely to know!
You ever been gang to me?
Let's think about it. No! You die! 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 Give him a clap for playing! Young man! You, the Biggie Smalls of this room. Yes! Yes! You've won a prize! Congratulations! You have won the sound of the death of a president! Right! Now, I will come down here, or perhaps here, or some other place. Wow! Who knew that by adding a projector to a simple corner stage, you would create an area impossible to get? My God, I feel literally like I used to with my Game Boy whenever I would play Pokemon and encountered a hedge that was slightly too high. It matters not. Move. Shift. Go. 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 Really? Not the table. That's why your show got cancelled. Oh, I moved it back. Yes, yes. That logic makes complete sense. Yes, yes. I know I kidnapped your daughter and killed her, but I put her back in her bed when I was done. Yes. I'm not going to lie. You just cost yourself a turn. Now. You. You will play.
Okay.
Yes, a positive attitude, a can-do kind of boy. Not the sort of woman who'd put on a yellow jumpsuit and kill a little girl. What is your name?
My name's Stuart.
Your name is what?
Stuart.
No. No, you little idiot. It's Darren. Darren! New Darren! Darren! All together!
You aim to find yourself in a dark room!
Make an option, Darren.
I'm just gonna go back to sleep.
Are you? Well, did you hear that noise? The sound of a room of people becoming disappointed in you? Little like your childhood, eh? Quite a lot like your adulthood, too, I suspect. And from what I can see, I am right. You sleep, and when sleep has ended,
you're awake to find yourself in a dark room!
Pick an option, Darren.
Check pockets.
Which one?
Yellow check pockets.
Congratulations, your pockets were made in the Czech Republic. It doesn't help you escape, but it's lovely to know.
Will you ever be kind to me?
Let's think about it. On one hand, well, you've been playing 10 seconds. On the other hand, this is the option that killed the last player. Now that makes me think to myself that you paid a bit of attention and you thought, I don't really want to play, I want to die, I want this to end. Which means the definition of kindness changes, doesn't it? Because if I were kind, you would die. You do not die. You awake
to find yourself in a dark room!
Pick an option, reluctant Darren. You proceed in the direction you believe to be north! How can you be sure you're in a dark room?
Abandon hope.
Well, that escalated quickly. You know! If you're going to abandon hope, her sisters, faith, and love, and charity as well. I never said you were alone in the dark room. There were four little girls with you. And you just abandoned them. Now they're dead. To be fair, this is the sort of behavior I'd expect from you. Four dead little girls, Darren. How does that make you feel?
Still a thing.
Yes! Yes! Over 300 times I've done this show, and over 300 times some fuckheads pick steal their things. This is the mark of a true gamer. Kill the children, loot the corpse. Yes. Yes. I think you'll find it's quite difficult to steal from immaterial concepts like faith and love and hope and charity. There were never any little girls. Sometimes I lie to you.
Find the light switch.
How will you find the light switch? You're in a dark room. You need the light switch to see. Do you see?
No.
That's a boring choice. Henceforth, all options will be interesting.
My Little Pony.
Yes, you have selected My Little Pony. All right, Darren.
Find a pony.
Congratulations, Darren. You found a pony. Good on you, Darren. Well done.
Ride pony.
Oh, what fun you're having, Darren. Clippity-clop, clippity-clop, clippity-clop. Tickety-clop, 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 tickety-clop. It's all the fun you never had when you were a child. Tickety-clop, tickety-clop, tickety-clop. It's all the fun you don't have it right now. Tickety-clop, 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 tickety-clop. Oh fuck, it fell down. Oh fuck, hang on. All of that exuberant clippity-clop turned off the controller. Your horse fell down.
Shoot the pony.
Oh dear, Darren, you horse-murdering swine. With its dying gasp, the pony kicks you in the brain. You die!
You die! You die! You die! You die! You die!
Enough. Only an English crowd can chant and then fade out like a recording. There's a room of people going, we have chanted. Ah, but the allocated amount of chance has been reached. Do we stop abruptly? We do nothing abruptly. You die!
You die.
I look eagerly forward to hearing the studio remix of this. Darren, what prize? What prize? For you, my darling. Yes. Yes, of course. Yes, Darren, yes! Yes, well done! This girl's jacket! Yes. Yes! Seemed to be made from real horse, too. Now, let's check the scores!
Check the pockets.
Ah, check the pockets. That's funny. It says game over. That's not true. I'm an only child. We'll play as long as I want. 25 minutes left on the board. No lives remaining. This is what we will do. We will have two more solo players. Do something a little special. Ah, how wonderful to know the phrase a little special can instill a new level of dread. As some of you go, this is special. This is as special as we wanted to get. Yes. You know how some people think laughter's a defense mechanism? It's really let you down today. I wouldn't have even known you were there. What is your name? It's Darren.
Lady Darren. Ovarian Darren.
Dundee Darren.
Darren, now is your chance to be a hero. All together, gang.
You're going to find yourself in a dark room.
Pick an option, my love.
How will you find the light switch? You're in a dark room! You need the light switch to see! Do you see?
I see.
Bullshit, you see! You're in a dark room!
Listen for the light switch.
You listen to the light switch. And it bores you with stories of the great war between electricity and steam. You can't kill yourself. You can't even find the light switch.
Leave them all and weep.
Oh! Too lazy for the normal weep option, eh? Right! This is you! Oh! I'm in a dark room!
Remember at school when they said you were unnecessarily dramatic about everything there? It's just happened again.
Oh! I'm in a dark room!
You weep, Darren. You weep and you weep and you weep and well done. You have found the light switch. Or, to be fair, your tears have.
Your tears trickle down the wall! Your cheers find the light switch! 1,000 bolts dance up your tears into your face! You die!
You die! You die! You die! You die! You die! You die! You die!
And now, young lady, rise! Oh, good. As it turns out, you've won bird flu, yes! My darling, well played. And it makes me so happy to see you smiling through what could only have been described as pain, yes. And that's how S&M works, ladies and gentlemen. Young lady, do you like pot noodle?
What flavor is it? You're a specific creature. You're going to enjoy this empty Pepsi Max bottle! Yes!
What flavor is it? Empty! Now!
20 minutes left on the board!
And our next player!
Aru!
What? What? Over in this part of the room where they translate what's going on, one of them just went, what the fuck was that?
The subtitling team's given up, boy! Who on earth was the person who decided to talk like Scooby-Doo telling me to fuck myself? Show me! Show me! You!
Yes, you! The one who looks like he used to work in a video store. Yes, you! God, it was sad when that whole medium let you down. Yes.
What is your name?
Darren.
Yes. And I will ask quite quickly, is it really?
It is now.
You're more right than you'll ever know. Together, gang.
Darren!
You're waiting to find yourself in a dark room!
You have an option, Darren.
Why?
Because it's dark, Darren!
Now, if you know all the words to one of these responses, chant along with me. It's remarkably like joining the Scientologists. But much cheaper. £3. The answer to why is this. Because it's dark, Darren! And a room, Darren! And you're awake in it, Darren!
Turn on my switch.
That's always been your problem, Darren. Self-esteem too high. Think you could turn on anything. Even inanimate objects. What? Would you turn the light switch on with?
With my finger.
Finally! Finally! Logic has come back! To the dark room. You would find the light switch with your finger. You would turn it on with your finger. If your finger could find the light switch. And your finger would be able to do that if your finger could see in the dark. Get it? Do you want to say that one again?
My finger is flipping you off.
You know, I don't want to seem unreasonably cruel. There's something nice about a man who commits wholeheartedly to a bad choice. There's something wonderful about a man who goes, my finger is flipping you off! And then when asked to repeat themselves, the way they say it completely undermines the message. Just a man saying, my finger is flipping you off. That question mark is what cut off your balls. Being castrated by punctuation. Your two balls have fallen and become a butt. Let me tell you something. You, well, to be fair, a question. What do you think that means? Show me now! Well done. Good! I am in Manchester, yes! Yes! Good! I did the show in a bar in Soho once, and a guy did this. It was in its own way, but it was. You! Flip me off! Bad news, Darren! I am not in the dark room. You are in the dark room, which means you flip off the shadows. And I don't mean Cliff Richard's opening bed. I just mean the darkness, and I don't mean them either. And let me tell you something, Darren. The darkness doesn't care.
Refuse to cry.
This is you. Oh! I'm in a dark room! Yeah! Now I won't cry. You're going to have to do a little more than that to stop you blubbing, my love. What will you do to stop yourself weeping?
Raise an eyebrow.
This is you. I'm in a dark room! Congratulations! Somewhere between the Rock and a member of the Sex Pistols. You do not die, Darren. You awake to find yourself in a dark room! Pick an option, mate. It's almost like doing that and raising your eyebrow had no practical effect.
Go north!
You perceive in the direction you believe to be north! How can you be sure you're in a dark room?
Wait.
Oh, no. Oh, no, no. Is this what pop culture has done to you? You think, oh, I'm trapped in a dark room. Oh, I do hope I'm not fat.
You weigh yourself.
You don't like what you find.
Click heels together for Stalin.
Click heels together for Stalin. Right up, 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 up.
That's up enough, yeah.
Click your heels together three times and say, there's no place like Leningrad.
Yes, there is, St. Petersburg.
No one said you could go down. Commit to the idea.
Yes, up, up. Now, do it again, but louder.
Correct. An entire room of people realize I literally just told you to stand up again.
I would like you to shout, there's no place like Leningrad, quite loudly indeed.
Do it now, go!
There is no place like Leningrad!
No, not
from St. Petersburg.
Pardon me?
Apart from St. Petersburg.
Don't depart from the script. we kind of have one. Do that again. Louder.
Go!
There is no place like Leningrad.
No! Not more articulate! Louder! One more time! Go!
There is no place like Leningrad!
Well done! Well done!
You may go. Sit. You are no longer alone in the dark.
Joseph Stalin! Is there with you?
And where Stalin goes, he brings with him nothing but death!
You die!
Yeah. Oh, good.
I like the fact that in an effort not to fade out again, you overcommit. A room of people, as every comedy crowd should, being there saying, no, we'll tell you when you die. Yes. Well done. Now, Dara, what prize
for a young man who in his hour of need thought socialism would fix everything?
That's right, nothing. It all belongs to the state.
Now, 11 minutes remaining. We will have one more solo player, and then the dark room democracy round. And in that round, everybody please. And just like in a real democracy, only the people with the loudest voices get what they want. Our final player has been selected. You! You will play. What is your name? Nearly. Welcome aboard, final Darren. All together.
You wait to find yourself in a dark room!
An option, do it quickly, go.
Why?
Because it's dark, Darren! And a room, Darren! And you're awakening, Darren!
Well done.
Sleep.
No.
Sleep.
Fine, you sleep. And when sleep has ended, think of this one.
You wait to find yourself in a dark room!
Pick an option, go. Why is this taking so long? Go! Which one? Really? That one?
No.
Yes. A question. Who thinks this one lives?
No.
Oh, correct. I am afraid that the Dark Room has enacted its no dickheads policy. You and him might want to go home and form a Megazord. No. Fuck it, take this, it's the same color as your armor.
One more solo player, who will it be?
I will.
Huh? What was that? There was a yay from here. Yes. Yes, it is bright. Imagine how hard this is for me. Yes.
What is your name?
Natalie.
I like it.
I like Darren better.
Everyone likes Darren. Darren. Second final Darren. To be fair, last supper Darren. Penultimate supper Darren. You know, the meal before the last supper. And they ate pot noodle. Darren, all together.
You wait to find yourself in a dark room!
Option, do it fast.
Go!
Find the light switch.
How will you find the light switch? You're in a dark room! You need a light switch to see! Do you see?
I see.
Bullshit, you see! You're in a dark room!
Touch the wall.
You caress the wall. It's indifferent to you.
I'll touch the other wall.
Now the first wall is jealous! You're just some kind of brickwork slut, aren't you? Now the walls have lost all respect for you! How did they have respect to lose their walls?
Smell the room.
The dark room smells of roomy darkness! You go west, life is peaceful there. You go east, it's like the west, but less decadent.
You pray to the heaven.
Sleep.
You sleep, and when sleep has ended, huh?
You wait to find yourself in a dark room!
I sleep.
Then you sleep again.
Plot point unlocked!
Well done, Darren.
Yes. Darren is quite ill, and sleeps a lot. It's not a great plot point, but fuck, there's a lot of them.
You sleep, and when sleep has ended,
you wait to find yourself in a dark room!
Pick an option.
Check pockets.
Which one?
Country.
Really? Really?
That one.
That's right, the other one. You see, I can't influence your choice, but what I want you to imagine is a room of strangers who didn't know you before. And you see, you made the mistake of saying your actual name. And see, what's happened is there's a room of strangers who, the minute you picked check pockets, thought to themselves, you know who I fucking hate? Natalie. So I would advise you, lest Last Supper Darren end up remarkably like the entertainment at the end of the actual Last Supper. Now we don't have the wood or the nails. Fuck it, we've got gumption.
Oh, spoilers.
Pardon me?
Spoilers.
Hey. Wow, that must have been fucking funny on the internet, man. I can literally hear the asterisks around your speech. Boy, he kills it on Reddit. Now, pick an option.
Check pockets, green.
Congratulations. You're wearing green check pockets. It's a hideous fashion choice, and you wouldn't have known because the room's so dark. But I decided to tell you.
And Gunnar.
Proceed in the direction you believe to be north. How can you be sure? You're in a dark room.
Time.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Don't
mind. Are you sure you'd like time?
Yeah, yeah.
Wouldn't you in fact prefer
any of these three rhyming options?
Wipe.
Wipe.
Yeah.
And what will you wipe? The surface of what?
The cactus. Oh, no! No! No!
Really?
Four options,
each more practical than the last. And then you wipe the cactus. I'm not gonna lie, my darling, I have no choice but to inform you.
You die! 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 You die!
Oh, love, your parents probably gave you a cactus as a kid, told you it was a cat, didn't they?
Look at this! Look at this cactus!
Oh, here. Have this rock. Actually, to be fair, let me give you something moderately less dangerous. There you go.
Right! There you go. There you are. Isn't that nice?
Finally, a place to live. What?
Oh.
Better? Now, the time has come for democracy. I like the fact that I interrupted some people exercising freedom of speech to inform them that now they could have democracy. Not just then, but now. You will have democracy on my terms. This is American democracy. Now, on the count of three, everyone will say,
"We awake to find ourselves in a dark room!"
Then, call out the option that you want. The winner is the one with the loudest and the most
group. One, two, three!
We awake to find ourselves in a dark room!
Selected, my finger can see. Your finger cannot see. It is a finger. But your finger can do a lot of special things to me. And here's why. Yes, Darren's. Plot point unlocked. You were born in Chernobyl. And unfortunately, according to the timer, we are out of time. I know. And you know, strange thing, I've been doing this show for 4 years. You might think to yourself, how can a show finish with the sound of people sighing and
evident displeasure. I will tell you that Les Mis has done that for 35 years. So endeth tonight's session of the Dark Room. If we could have those lights up, that'd be just great. Right, hello.
Yo.
Hey, man. Well, yeah, well, as it turns out, I was Australian the whole time. my name is John Robertson. That is my Twitter handle there, at Robotron. If you would like to, I'd be very glad to have you follow me. I tour all around the UK with this show. The next big one of these I'm doing is February 24th in Nottingham at the Broadway Cinema. And just before we head off, a couple of things. One, I'd like very much to thank the lovely people of Trapdoor Comedy.
Yeah! Yeah!
They let me stay at their house. And you know, I'm dressed like this. they had a cat once. Who knows what happened?
Thank God.
Now, here it is now. I would very much enjoy it. Sophie, if you could grab one of the shirts.
I've got this thing here. But I've also got a model.
Do you have the other shirts?
No, they're not.
Use the model.
But we have the model.
Oh, you've got the model.
No, I'll come back in a second, just use the
shirt. Oh, okay, yeah, thanks, Tony, good on you. Wonderfully seamless. Just to let you know, what we have is we've got some darkroom merchandise. I have 5 more of these left, so this is the last, this particular run of stock. These are darkroom t-shirts. They read very, very simply, Darren.
Richard Obama.
Pardon me?
Richard Obama.
Yeah, I know I won't be doing that much.
It's James Dallin.
I know that. You give it to the fucking bar. Now, the thing is, and I will say to the actual Darren over there, because occasionally I get asked by guys whose name the Darren, like, well, what the fuck's your problem? What's your problem with the name Darren? Yes. It's funny, no? Nah, it's not true. It's just I wanted to give one particular name, and I picked that one. But yeah, I have 5 of these left to sell. It's £10 for one, £15 for two. But we go up, we go small, medium, large, XL sold out really fast, because I know my audience. And just before, because I'm going to go down just near the only exit, and I'll be there with the shirts. If you want one, come on by. If you want to have a photo with the gear, I'll keep it on for a fair bit. Come down, have a photo, tweet at it over there. That'd just be lovely. And before we go, because I'm not going to lie, I'm about to catch a mega bus to London, and I don't want this shit. The pineapple. I feel that this must be given away to the person who contributed most beautifully to tonight's show, and well, there can only be one, can't there? Just like the Highlander. There you go. And also, you two young girls down here, you have a pot noodle to share. merely because when I came out before the show began, I put the pineapple there, and yeah, I heard you, all right? These two girls went, "Why is there a pineapple?" And I was just like, I can't explain myself. It's a lot of fun. You, I didn't spot you at all. That's a pet rock. There you go, mate. When puberty comes, you won't need that. if I could have some party poppers, it's your birthday. Right, that's just technically litter. I probably wasn't meant to be there.
Don't forget the piece of gum.
What's that, mate?
The piece of gum.
Oh, is that yours?
No, it's from that girl.
Oh, it's from what girl?
The first comedian.
Oh, the first comedian. Oh, did Lou put some gum?
She left it
there. Wow.
Yeah.
What a fantastic finale.
think I've ever had a show finish on such a dull trivia. I've just taped all of this, and what I'm going to do when I go home is I imagine I might just pop on the director's commentary just for fun on YouTube and just be like, and it was at this point that one young woman went, on that gum. That was left there by the first act. And a room of people who didn't previously know that were forced to know that. No, none of us knew.
You poor love, God, you've had a hard night.
Sitting there next to that gum, waiting for someone to acknowledge it.
Traumatised.
Oh, God, fuck off, back to Tumblr.
Well, it's been...
As his attempt to leave the stage entered its 10th minute. You've been a very lovely group of people. It's been a great pleasure. As I walk down here, please don't take the fact I'm clearly holding this as some message or anything. But yeah, it's been a great joy. My name is John Robertson.
Okay, so admin, I'm gonna get